नेशनल एक्सपेंसेस इज दैट एक्सपेंस विच वन मेक्स विथ हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ.
वेयर यू पे रेंट टू योरसेल्फ.
एग्जांपल, सो सपोज यू हैव अ बिल्डिंग एंड इट्स योर ओन बिल्डिंग एंड यू आर रनिंग फोर प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड यू चार्ज 20,000 रुपीज रेंट टू ईच प्रोजेक्ट. So, what happens? It's your building. You are not paying any rent to anybody, but you are charging and recovering 20,000 rupees per project for four projects, 80,000 rupees per month. But let us understand this whole concept. So, what happens is, donor funds are restricted grants, right? So, when you charge the donors, their grant balance goes down. But actually, on the other hand, you are taking it to your general reserves or other funds of the organization, and the organization funds go up. So when you report to the donor, you report that this was spent. But on the other hand, this is not actually spent because you require two different parties to have a transaction, to have two independent parties to have a transaction, a valid transaction, right? So, suppose you have you hire a taxi, the taxi driver is another person. So, you pay the taxi driver and then taxi driver give you a service. Now, suppose it's your car. And then if you pay yourself per kilometer, let's say 15 rupees, because that is what, or say 18 rupees, I don't know, what these Meru cabs charge. 19. So, then there is some amount of notional income, because not the whole 19 is notional, because you have spent on petrol and other things, maybe 8 rupees or 9 rupees. So another 10 rupees per kilometer is what is notional, which gets generated.
But why would you pay
yourself? That's what. So therefore it is like having a transaction with oneself. It's like taking some money from your one pocket and putting it in another pocket. So in the net result, in the overall analysis, in the financial statements, there is no net cash outflow, therefore there is no net transaction. It's just a journal entry from one project to your general fund or wherever.
So it's not a private thingy. As in, it's not, the money hasn't gone into your private pocket, it's still gone into your...
Into the organization.
Okay.
Now, this is a very prevalent practice within the NGO sector today. Now, the ethics part of it, we will have to deal with. See, first of all, notional expenses, because we are coming into budget, so therefore we are discussing this. Notional expenses is, first, it is an issue of transparency. Whether the donor knows, is aware that this amount is charged or not, that's where your issue comes up. You know, whether it's cheating, it depends on whether the donor knows or not. If the donor is allowed that, well, you can charge so much for, you know, meeting up your administrative cost, overhead cost, which we are not meeting, etc., etc., then it is possible.
But then why wouldn't the donor just say, okay, spend it on your admin costs? Why go through this?
No.
Giving certain expenses, so this comes with
that. No, it depends. Actually, what happens also is that, what kind of donor? For example, if a donor is not a long-term donor, and like USAID sometimes would like to give you a grant and say that 15% we give you for overheads. You don't report only, you just take 15%. If you spend more, it's your headache. If you spend less, it's your saving. So like that, there are various donors who should say like that. So first of all, whether there is transparency within is a very important issue. Secondly, I think it's also very important to see that the amount that we are or the project that we are implementing out of donor funds. The philosophy behind running a project is that, you know, we as an organization, we are called to serve, and we have a mission in mind and we want to do that work. Now, while doing it, we realize that there is a need for external support and therefore we go to donors, right? So what we can bring in, we should bring in first before even asking a donor to support. Many times these, we also look at it like a for-profit agency. You know, then they will say, oh, if I would have taken a place on rent, it would have cost me so much, so I'm using it in my premises. So as a good practice, I think it is important that not to make money out of project. So if there are actual expenses incurred, for example, for upkeep and maintenance and so on, you can charge it, I mean, with the knowledge of the donor. But charging in a camouflage manner of a particular amount is somehow there is a lack of transparency there. So notional costs are, first of all, there should be transparency with the donor. And secondly, as much as possible, actual expenses can be charged or should be charged, and not a notional sort of a expenditure.